Oxygen, an atmospheric gas, increases saturation of hemoglobin oxygen, and when used at therapeutic concentrations, may aid the oxygenation of certain tissues as long as the patient is not in shock or has some other complication like carbon monoxide poisoning, which could affect the distribution or reception of oxygen within the body and its cells. The primary indications for the use of oxygen in ACLS are the presence of hypoxemia, which would be an SpO2 less than 94%, severe respiratory depression, or distress as in asthma, respiratory distress, or depression as in opioid overdose. Now, when administering oxygen therapy after the return of spontaneous circulation, otherwise known as ROSC, it's important to deliver sufficient oxygenation to maintain an SpO2 that's greater than or equal to 94%, but less than 100%. There are few, if any, known contraindications for oxygen use in the true hypoxic patient. Precaution should be based on new and ongoing research revealing the vasoconstrictive properties that hyperoxia may produce. Now, if we begin to hyperoxygenate a normoxic cardiac patient, some theories and studies indicate that we could be causing lower oxygen absorption and distribution to vital organs that need oxygenation during a coronary crisis. The appropriate dose of oxygen is really dependent upon the needs of the patient and their unique oxygen requirements. Now, that being said, oxygen has several different methods for delivery, and the percentage of oxygenation is regulated by the flow of oxygen per minute and the delivery adjunct used. Now, if oxygen delivery by nasal cannula is indicated, it would be delivered at a rate of 2 to 6 liters per minute. If a nonrebreather mask is used, the flow rate increases to 12 to 15 liters per minute. Now, if the respiratory distressed or depressed, or those who are apneic completely, the delivery of oxygenated ventilations would be delivered via a positive pressure device like a bag valve mask. In this case, oxygen flow should be set at 15 liters a minute. It's important that under current guidelines, we are titrating oxygen therapy to maintain an SpO2 of at least 94%, but less than 100%. It's vital to remember that a restricted airway will affect the therapeutic response of the oxygenation treatment. Use of a basic or advanced airway adjunct may be needed in order to open or maintain an open and patent airway in order to treat the patient effectively. Now, remember to monitor the patient's signs and symptoms along with the electronic and technical monitoring systems so as to treat the patient effectively. In other words, if the SpO2 reads 92%, but the skin appears normal in the patient, maybe they have an underlying blood disorder like anemia, which could impede the cyanosis due to a lack of hemoglobin and give an inaccurate appearance of adequate oxygenation.